Rudolf Rigler was a student, had finished his thesis at the Karolinska Institute in Stockholm. And he met me when I got the Nobel Prize in 67 and asked whether he could come to Göttingen and do postdoctoral work with me. Of course, he was invited to come, so he came. And there he had the idea to get down to small sizes. We have talked about fluctuations. We have said fluctuations go with the square root of the number of events you are watching. So he had the idea of looking at fluctuations rather than on average values, where the fluctuations are a small percentage of it. Look directly to the fluctuation. There was a group in America also. It was Webb in Professor Webb's laboratory at Cornell University. There were Magde and Elson, who also worked out a method which they called fluorescence correlation spectroscopy. And independently, it was done in Stockholm by Rudolf Rigler. But the root was his time at Göttingen in the end of the 60s. That was long before the other paper came out. He had the idea of looking at fluctuations, got together with Leo de Meyer, whom I mentioned before, with whom we did the neutralization kinetics. And Leo de Meyer, meanwhile, has become a professor and has his own group. And Leo and Rudolf went on to whether they could see the fluctuations directly. For that, they chose one of the very early lasers which became available. And they saw big fluctuations, wonderful. But unfortunately, it was a fluctuation of the laser light, so the lasers were not yet very stable. And simply, at that time, technology wasn't yet ready for that. But Rudolf kept the problem in mind and developed it steadily when he returned to Stockholm and worked out a method to determine the rotation of single molecules.